Welcome to On the Media. I'm Ryder Shingothi. I interviewed my mom, who's 54 years old. Why don't you guys start by introducing yourselves?
I'm Mark Campbell. I interviewed my grandma, Lynn Campbell, and she was 74 years old.
I'm Norby. I interviewed a family friend. His name is Brian Bankin. He's known me pretty much all my life, and he's very good friends with my mom.
I'm Mackenzie Cooley. I interviewed my mom, Heather Cooley, and she's 48.
Okay, now that we've all introduced ourselves, we can start jumping into our questions. For our first question, I asked my mom about her social media usage, and she responded to me by saying, "I don't even know how to TikTok or Instagram." And then she continued to explain that she only really uses Facebook to keep in touch with her friends on that app. So what were you able to find, Mark?
My grandma doesn't really use the social media often. She only has Facebook and messages. So she only just tries to keep up with our close family.
My person told me that he really likes Facebook because he's able to reach out to people in different states. So, for example, he has grandkids in Virginia that he's able to see what's going on. And he said that was better than back in the day when they had to write letters and postcards.
My mom uses Facebook. She recently just got Snapchat, so I'm teaching her how to use that. She likes having it at her fingertips, but said it can be a crutch for some people.
I think it's interesting how the older generations tend to really only use Facebook and how they don't really use the apps that we use as much. And it's funny because I don't even know how to use Facebook, and I myself have never even used Facebook. For our next question, I asked about how our generation is often referred to as digital natives, and as opposed to an evolution to technology. And then I asked my mom if she thought that was a good or a bad thing. She responded to me by saying that she was there before and she was there after. Our generation has never really known what it's like to live without technology, and she feels as though we are so instantly gratified by having technology and we lose like part of our patience to that. What were you able to find, Mark?
My grandma thinks it's definitely a positive thing for our generation to have our technology. We can use it as resources to find out or to be more media literate. And she says it's a great way to just keep up with the world.
My person said that his generation would be kicked out of the house and not told not to come back until sunset. And he told me he remembers like finding turtles and climbing trees for fun, and he feels that our generation is missing out on the outdoors.
My mom said it's more of a positive because the way the future is going, that we're more tech savvy and we have more of a digital imprint, but that we couldn't expect to survive in the 70s and 80s because of what we have now.
Our next question I asked my mom was if she remembered writing letters and sending postcards. And the response she gave me was that she found that it was really exciting and really fun to send letters to people. She told me that she would go on vacations and go to things like summer camps. And instead of taking people's numbers down, they would take down their address. And then you would send the letter and some time would go by and you'd receive the letter in the mail. And she thought that was a really fun and exciting experience compared to texting, which is such an instant way of communication. What were you able to find, Mark?
My grandma definitely agreed. She definitely thinks that was the way she communicated back then. She went on vacation a lot, and every time she did, she would send the letters and postcards, and it would cost her about 3 cents a stamp, probably like a little bit more just to send the letter. But it would always take 3 to 5 like days for it to actually go to the recipient. So it definitely took a while for everybody to really like know what you were doing, rather than sending out an email saying I'm on vacation to the Bahamas or something, It was very slow back then.
My person told me that he lived overseas when he was younger, so he would have to write letters back to the U.S. because the phone lines really wouldn't reach the U.S. They would have bad connection. He told me that letters were more like emails today and postcards were more like modern day texting. And he told me he was kind of upset how informal texting and emails have become.
My mom said yes, that she wrote a lot of postcards, especially in the summer, to her grandparents in Wisconsin. She said that they would also write back, and then when she went to sports camps such as volleyball and softball, she would write to her parents to update them. And she said 21 cents comes to mind when talking about mail compared to how much more expensive it is today to send out.
Our final question is going to be regarding if the people we interview feel that our phones are listening to them. And an example that my mom gave me, if she felt that her phone was listening to her, was when she was shopping for shoes online, and then she went on Facebook and saw an exact ad for the shoe that she was looking for. Did the person that you interviewed see this, Mark?
Yeah, so my grandma definitely believes our phones are tapped, same with computers and TVs. And it took her, as soon as we got off the call, like after my interview with her, we had an off conversation about something, and she had gotten an ad for it almost immediately, like 10 minutes later, if anything. Yeah, and she, like, while I was asking her about this question, she also said that, like, Big Brother is spying on you, right? And I thought it was funny, but then she also, like, gave me an explanation of that her TV is not tapped because it's just so old, which I thought was really funny.
My person told me that he remembers talking to his wife about a very specific item, and then he remembers going on Facebook later that day and seeing that exact item, so he thought that was weird. He then went on to tell me about how he thinks his camera is watching him, so he'll put a sticky note over it just in case.
My mom said that she thinks it's a huge concern. She wonders why she didn't click on something, though she was thinking of it. She has inside joke with her doctors of, can you hear me now? Can you hear me now? But she thinks that the internet has... our phones and internet is tapped into, but one day we will find those hidden controls, but right now we don't know them.
Okay, well, that's all the time we have for today. Thank you for joining us here on the Media.